So, I did want to show you guys how I start my paintings. I've had a few people asking me and how I do them all the way through. I really can't show that at this time. Like, I put a canvas this big, I'll put over 200 hours in it sometimes. But I can show you how I start. I often call this my free my spirit paintings. This is plein air, but that doesn't mean that I actually do what's in front of me. So, anyhow, I'm gonna go ahead and just start. I did just jump turpentine all over me. Been in a hyper kind of bad mood and shared some crabby videos on Facebook, which I usually don't do, but anyhow, this I will have via YouTube, I believe. So here goes. Let's see what I can do. Let's see what I can show you. And how I start, I don't think I'm gonna explain much. You guys can watch what I do. I don't think painting like me is anything anybody will ever do, just like I don't paint like anybody else. So I think it's all about starting, doing what you want to do, enjoying it. There are rules that people follow. A lot of people go out of the rules, get amazing paintings. I do both. My favorite palette knife so far. Gonna start with five colors. I have a dirty board. I didn't clean it last night, which means I'll get more colors to mix. I didn't use any turpentine or any drying stuff last night, so it's still nice and soft. Sometimes I do that because it's fun. So anyhow, I'm just gonna start my board off and let you guys see what I do. some of you, this may seem inefficient, or I don't know. It doesn't really honestly matter. But for me, this is my way of getting my energy out before I really decide on what I'm going to paint. I just love color. I feel like I'm a colorist, first of all. So as I continue, I love the scraping sound of palette knives. Palette knives are so much fun for me, and just one of the ways I get some color into a painting first. But it doesn't have to be that way. I start with I'll start with brushes plenty of times, and I'm probably going to switch to a brush here in a minute and just put in more color with that. For this, I didn't put any sort of other mediums in with the oil right at the moment. So that's where I'm at, and I'm going to just take everything off my palette and mix it into a sort of gray. Basically, all your colors will always mix into a sort of gray that gives you those in-between tones to what you're painting. So that's where I'm at. Really have a raspy voice today because I kind of yelled at everybody on Facebook. And if you're on my Facebook page, you'll hear it. But I do have a public page, so if you feel like going over there and listening to my yelling, I've been on a year and I'm just kind of over some of the things that go on there. And I don't mean to be mean to people, but I do mean to stand up for myself when I've gotten tired of essentially people's bad behavior. A bit of liquid now. To put in some good drawing stuff. And I think what I'm going to do now, just use white and liquid. Use whatever's on my board, maybe a little bit of turpentine. So I shared that essentially I have turned this into like a brown gray from all the colors that are on my board. More brown because there is, you know, if you've got a deep red on your board, it's going to obviously turn more into a brown type of thing. So I'm just mixing white and liquid and the colors that are on my board together. It is a dry climate out here, that's for sure. So I might have put a little bit more liquid than I needed, so you don't want to put too much because I believe it's about a 1/3 to 2/3 at the most is what you want for liquid to your oil paint so that you don't end up having yellowing over time. And there's plenty of YouTube videos, online videos, just knowledge out there, books, whatever you want to do if you're going to start oil painting. There's plenty of that stuff out there for you to learn the chemistry of what you need to do. Now, I already have a pretty good idea of chemistry because I was a firefighter for years. Plus, I've been a baker for years. I'm good at both. I was good at chemistry in both. Science and chemistry kind of come easy to me. But if you need to think through it and figure it out, because you haven't played with chemistry during your lifetime, it's a good call if you're wanting your paintings to last. I want my paintings to be archival. I want to show at some of the biggest places in the world, and I want to sell high. So that's what I'm working on, is making every painting being archival. So I'm not going to waste the paint that's on my palette knife. Pretty color though. And then I'm just gonna put that on for now. And I'll use my brush now. And I have my brush dipped in oil right now, softening. I did clean them earlier with turpentine. I erased that video because anyways, I told you I've gotten a rant, and I believe sometimes when you get in a rant, you just do things that aren't really good for you. And so I, being a little high strung today, instead of just going into painting, I shared it on video, which is fine. I feel like honestly, sometimes you just gotta say what you gotta say. But then when I came out here, found this spot, set up, I dumped a whole jar of turpentine, like strong turpentine, all over my leg. Fortunately, I had some baby oil with me, wiped off my leg with that and wiped that down. Otherwise, you would burn pretty bad over time if you left it on there. So anyhow, what's gonna go through, and as you can see now, my paint is much more liquid. I am going to just go ahead and paint a lot of this in to begin with. I want a lighter canvas down below. I'm not going to touch these other colors yet, but I will blend in a bit. Already doing that accidentally, but not that big. for me, it's just about having fun, getting those first layers on. My idea is just coming out. And my idea, so for one thing too, is like if you are into just covering the canvas first with just one color, then go for it. That is how a lot of painters paint. You know, they do a base layer. I use primed canvases, so I don't need to prime them. But some people like to have their canvases essentially started with a neutral color so that they can go dark and light. Use up the paint on my board. Now, this is just what I decided to do just now, which is add a little turpentine and start. I feel like your first layer often needs to be fairly thin, but not all the time. So, as long as you've got the right ingredients, going on with what you're doing, the right chemistry makeup, then yes, it takes a longer time to dry, but it's not absolutely essential that you keep that first layer lighter.